Hey, what's up, my little Titles host? Listen, remember when I told you I would drag down more information on what exactly is going on with Courtney, her family, and also her wedding to Travis Barker? Listen, a lot of you guys know from my last video, I made a big deal about her kids not being there, saying, guys, I don't care what you say, something's off, it's a little weird. A lot of you guys were saying, well, maybe she just wanted a day for herself. She's getting married in Italy. The kids didn't need to be there. You're making a big thing out of nothing, and I want to tell all of you, you guys just won't open your eyes to the truth because new evidence has emerged from Scott Disick's mouth about the kids that they were very hurt about not being invited to the wedding. Also, the fact that People.com is oddly dropping comments about the third wedding will be in Italy. We'll talk about that. And more importantly, how even though they weren't invited, it was only a ceremony and they might not have been able to invite the whole clan to the courthouse. Only one sister and her mom wished her congratulations on her wedding. You guys, I told you something was amiss and now we're about to get into it. Y'all ready for this? Let go. But before we do, y'all, I'm trying to get to 1 million. You know what I'm about to ask? Begging, baby, please hit the like button, notifications, subscribe and notifications if you're not your first time here. But you know what? It doesn't matter. Let's get into this. But please hit the like for the algorithm. Let go. Okay, first of all, before we get into the mess, can we just pause and just admire? I think Courtney looks absolutely stunning on her wedding day. And if I was to get married, baby, I would do a something like this. I'm not even joking. Listen, you don't marry a rock god every day. And Courtney, you made us proud. Look at this. You got the Madonna shawl going. You got your body, adi, adi. You got the 4-inch pumps. Your man is tatted and ready. I love their vibe. It's like young at heart forever, California rock god. Anyway, yo, I'm loving the vibe of the whole wedding. Okay, let me stop fangirling and let's get into the best. First of all, let's talk about how you guys were all wrong. I get the fact that maybe they couldn't come to the courthouse, but the fact that nobody met her afterwards for the courthouse, the fact that there was no get together with family and friends at the house or on the gram, the fact that only Khloe Kardashian and Kris Jenner even publicly acknowledged her wedding or wished her well, y'all can say what y'all want about, oh my God, they're gonna be in Italy. Y'all, it don't matter what your family's like, nobody's gonna do that, especially the Kardashians who live their life on public social media. They don't do nothing private, especially not this. And it has not gone unnoticed that they put their congratulations on their Instagram stories, not even their main feed. I guess it's true what they say. They're like, if you're not making the family any dollars, it just don't make sense to be happy for you. Again, now let's get to the Scott stuff because that's when things get deep. All right, let's lay the basics down because a lot of y'all doubted that, oh, maybe the kids weren't allowed inside. They were this, they were that. Scott has confirmed that the kids were with them. He literally captured a post on Instagram talking about living the dream where it was him, his 12-year-old son, Mason, and his 9-year-old daughter, Penelope, where he captioned their story, pushing P. All right, so everybody on the same page, the kids were there, but Scott went further and spoke about how the kids were really heartbroken about not being included and that they should have made more of an effort to invite them. Let's go. Okay, now I do want to point out that Scott's comments were actually about the kids not being invited to the engagement, but I think it's pertinent to our little investigation, Tattletales. Let me know what you think, or let me know if you think I'm reaching, because if they felt this way about not being invited to the engagement, what do you think that they felt about not being invited to a courthouse wedding? Again, I'll say it once and I say it again. I think it's weird when you have young minor children that love their mommy and daddy that literally happened. Courtney literally said that the kids were a little bit upset when she got engaged and whatnot because Mason wouldn't get on the phone. Penelope started crying. Mason hung up on her. Rain started crying. Penelope was like so mad because they're like, what does this mean? Does this mean you're not going to be our mommy anymore? They were super scared that when you got married, that when you got engaged, that meant that you were going to be pulled away from your children. And these same children that just had the fears, you go and get married at a courthouse and they see it all over social media where you're so happy without them and dressed up. Why wouldn't you want to Again, I love Courtney. Okay, I don't know her, but who she portrays on TV to be, she seems like the most normal one. Please, God, don't let poor Courtney do anything problematic. But to me, and everybody's family's different, I'm not judging anybody for the choices they made. But for me and my friends and family and the way I was raised, and if you have minor children, and this is arguably one of the biggest, most sentimental days of your life, you will want them there at the actual wedding, even if they couldn't come into the courthouse, waiting outside, or to have a party with them and include them, especially when they made it known that not being included in the engagement made them feel like they were losing their mommy. Now let's look at what Scott had to say. Okay, so on the engagement, Scott later revealed that the kids were upset that they were excluded from the celebrations and told Khloe Kardashian that they didn't understand why they were watching TikToks of his kids there. This is Travis's kids, and that their kids were not included. But it wasn't over. He went on to say, hopefully they're invited to the wedding. Am I invited to the wedding? The sad part is the fact that a lot of people, and again, I don't mean to talk down to anybody. It's just, I'm speaking from a place of hurt. If it was me and I put myself in those little kids' position, I would be incredibly hurt that the ceremony that meant something to your heart, right? You excluded me from, and you're saying, oh, but you can celebrate with the friends, family, strangers, business managers. I don't know, I would want to be right there in the center. Scott literally went on to say, me personally, if I got engaged 50 minutes away, I would have just said, someone get in a car and get my kids here. And P would have been ecstatic. He was saying that Penelope was so hurt that she wasn't involved. He went on to say, we're acting as if the place was 10 hours away. They can have their life. I just don't want to be pushed out of family affairs that include the kids and things we normally would do. I just don't want to lose the dynamic of having all you guys. Now, I know Scott was mixing in his own issues, but you guys, there is something going on. You guys, like, subscribe, turn your notifications on, because you know I'm gonna follow this story to the bitter end. But I'm telling you, there is something going on, and maybe her kids got caught in the crossfire. I don't want to think anything bad of Courtney, even though I don't know her, and she was raised by Kris Jenner. So who knows? Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? But you guys, let me know in the comments what you think. Again, I think it's so messed up the kids weren't included. Nobody publicly thanked her except for Khloe and her mom. Khloe and her mom put it on Instagram stories, and now they're having a taped wedding in Italy. You guys, something's going on. Courtney's rebelling again, but why weren't her kids included? I just gotta know. All right, y'all, talk to you later.